So, Windrush Aerodrome on the 27th of September, quite early in the morning, because we were not expecting the weather to stay good for very long. In fact, we weren't really expecting the weather to be as good as this as it is. So what I want to do today is just to take the plane up and have a little local flight along the west bank of the Huon Estuary. To begin with, I'm going to head off down to the south, down towards Cygnet Water, and then at about 2,000 feet, and then turn around, come back towards Port Huon, and just before I get there, head off to the left and go and have a look at Geeveston, and then from there on we'll decide, depending on what the weather's like and what the air feels like. So we'll turn here and do the run-ups, and then make sure the flaps are set, single set stage of flaps, and off we'll go. And climb reasonably quickly up to up towards 500-600 feet, turn to the left and continue climbing through to 2,000 feet as we head down towards Cygnet Water. So the flaps are off, and as you can see, the surface of the estuary is absolutely mirror-like. There's almost no wind now that I'm here, just a little bit of turbulence as we were clearing the trees on the run off the end of the runway, but now it's absolutely beautiful up here. You can see just as we turn Port Huon with the jetty, which from which we used to export apples back to England and the rest of the world, but now is the home of Huon aquaculture, and it's basically the hub from which we grow trout and salmon in the estuary here, and elsewhere around Tasmania actually, and it's all basically brought back here for packing and dispatch and so on and so forth. So we're going to head on down to Cygnet Water and continue on our climb to about 2,000 feet. So that expanse of water which you can see to the left is Cygnet Water, and if we were to follow that, that would take us into, first of all, Port Cygnet and then Cygnet itself. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn to the right and retrace my steps back towards Port Huon, and before we get there we'll shoot off to the left. So if you look directly over that promontory of land, which is sticking out from the right-hand bank there, you'll see on the left-hand bank a sort of a notch, and that's Port Huon. But what we're going to do now is we're going to turn away to the left from the river and head up to the west a little way, and then retrace our tracks a little bit further to the north. And fly over Geeveston. Then, once we get to Geeveston, we'll decide where to go from there. And as we skirt around behind these hills, just slightly to the west of the river, you'll see we're going to pass over a rather pretty little lake. And straight ahead of us, over the top of the lake, is Geeveston. Going to turn slightly to the right now and go for the top of Geeveston, which is a quite a pretty town from the air, but in fact is a logging town which is practically dead since the end of the logging industry a few years ago. It was quite a thriving town until about four or five years ago, when basically the logging in this area was stopped and some mills closed down, lots of people lost their jobs, and many of the citizens of Geeveston ended up going and getting jobs fly in, fly out, jobs in the mines in Western Australia and in Queensland. So we'll fly over the top of Geeveston and then continue to veer on to the right and go back to join the river at Franklin, and then we'll head up towards Huonville from there. For those of you who haven't been flying with me before, the silt in the centre of the estuary here, which is basically clogging up the river, is called Egg Islands, and is a waterbird sanctuary, so nobody's ever going to dredge it, sadly, and all it does is act to make the flooding in Huonville worse, really. However, I'm mine not to reason why. we're just passing along the river just off Franklin, which is that long thin town running along the western bank there beside Egg Island. And we're going to continue along the river and head up to the bridge at Huonville. And at that point, the river takes a turn to the left, and we're going to continue following it at, and maintaining a couple of thousand feet. As we head up to the north and the river starts to narrow, you'll shortly see the bridge at Huonville. Huonville is that town between the hills directly ahead of us, and Huonville is the capital of this part of the world these days, mainly because, I suppose, of the bridge, which allows access to both banks of the river. It's the last bridge across the river. And we are going to follow the river. If we were to go straight ahead and then sort of bear off to towards the northeast, we'd arrive at Sandfly and end up in Hobart. That those ranges over there are the Wellington Ranges, and the very eastern end is Mount Wellington, which overlooks Hobart City. But anyway, we're not going to go that way. We're going to wait until the western bank comes down towards the river at the bridge, and we're going to turn left to follow the remainder of the upriver part of the Huon Valley. Straight towards a town called Judbury, and we're not going to go all the way to Judbury, but we'll pass over a small town called Glen Huon, and then then we'll start to turn left and to climb to 3,000 feet and come back towards Geeveston. I want to go around the hill where the radio and television transmitters are, and the mobile phone transmitters are, which is just to the north of Port Huon, somewhere between Geeveston and Port Huon, and then we'll come in and land back at Windrush International. Now it's time to make our turn to the left and climb to 3,000 feet and track for Geeston again around the back of the transmitter hill. As you'll see as we go through here, this is going to be fairly wild country. There's just trees underneath us. It's not heavily settled at all, this particular part of the track, and you'll see the folds in the hills. It's all really rather beautiful. Shortly we'll begin our descent down towards Geeveston, which is the pale green that you can see, area of pale green that you can see in front of us, and we'll try to get there at about 1,500 feet and then turn for Port Huon and continue our descent with the aim of getting there at about 700 feet. So it's a long cruise descent really from here, if we want to be at the right position to be able to get into to Windrush International across the other side of the river. as we pass the hill now, which has got the television and mobile phone radio towers on it, and continue our descent down into towards Geeveston. We'll shortly begin to turn left and track for Port Huon and continue our descent down to hopefully around about 700 feet by the time we get there. So Port Cygnet straight ahead of us, and the point sticking out of the left-hand side of the Port Cygnet Bay is where we're aiming for. You'll see that the jetty comes out from there as we track over it, and you'll see Port Huon Town as we head towards that area. In all honesty, I'm a bit high, and I suspect I'm going to have to do a little circle partway down here to just lose a bit of height before I make my final approach to the runway. Well, I'm definitely a little bit high. I need to lose 300 or 400 feet before I make the final approach. So what I'll do is I'll orbit round to the left, lose that 300 or 400 feet as best I can in the loop, and then make my final approach to Windrush International Airport runway 09. So we've lost enough height, we've lost enough speed, and it's now time to put the flaps on and make our final approach towards runway 9. So we go over between these, this gap between the trees, and then head over the top of the dams, follow along what used to be the vineyard, and we'll see a sort of ramp of earth which leads up to the taxiway at the very beginning of the runway, and then just allow the plane to drift and turn marginally towards the right, and we'll touch down fairly easily. So as you can see, the plane slows down very quickly on the 1-in-10 hill, which is runway 09 at Windrush International Airport, and we'll turn around and go down to the hangar now, and thank you very much for flying with us in Windrush International Airways on our sightseeing tour over the western bank of the Huon Estuary and up the Huon River from Huonville.